If you hear any yelling or music, it's because it's outside. I have very noisy neighbors and it is summer in New York City, so that's what you're just gonna get. Hello, my lovelies. I'm Heather and welcome back to my channel, The Happenings with H.A.P., H.A.P. meaning my initials. I wanted to do something a little bit different. So since I started this channel in June, I did not get to do a 2020 new releases that I'm most excited for type of video. So I figured why not do a mid-year 2020 TBR. We're halfway through the year. We still have 6 more months of books to be released. So why not let you know what books that I'm excited about? Whether I'll get to them this year is another story, but I'm definitely excited about them and they're already on my TBR. So maybe they can be on yours too. Let's get into it. First book we have is Cinderella's Dead by Kalynn Bayron, and this comes out July 7th. The premise for this book is pretty interesting. Essentially, Cinderella is a real person in this universe, and it's 200 years after her fairy tale romance with her prince. Now, every year in this kingdom, an annual ball is held for teen girls to go to and find their husbands based on how beautiful they are, how fine their dresses are, and everything else. However, if they do not find a husband at this ball, they aren't heard from again. This premise really got me, and I don't need to know more because I want to read it. Next up, we have Splinters of Scarlet by Emily Bain Murphy, and this comes out July 21st. So when I find new books to read, it's usually through suggestions on BookTube or just my own kind of searching through what's coming out on Goodreads or places like that. The first sentence of the synopsis actually is what drew me in. Enchanté meets Downton Abbey. Enchanté has actually been on my TBR for a while. I've yet to read it. However, I know it's supposed to be a loose adaptation of Les Miserables. Thinking of that combined with Downton Abbey, there's a lot of ways this could go. It's a YA historical fiction set in 19th century Denmark. And magic is something that's real. And from what I gathered from the synopsis, the more you use it, the more it kills you. It's a buildup in your bloodstream called the fern. So I don't know too much more about it. I don't really want to know too much more, but I'm very intrigued. Next up we have Where Dreams Descend by Janella Angelis, and that's coming out August 25th. This one is the first in a new series called The Kingdom of Cards, and it is about a group of magicians that have a magical duel with each other in order to be the next headliner in the conquering circus. This is kind of giving me some Night Circus vibes, and I'm definitely here for it. I loved Night Circus, so if it's anything like that, I'm definitely gonna love this one. Next we have The Lost Book of the White by Cassandra Clare and Wesley Chu, and this comes out September 1st. This book is the second in the Eldest Curses trilogy. This trilogy is actually an adult trilogy for the Shadowhunter universe, and it primarily is following Alex and Magnus. And I was not the biggest fan of the first book, but I love Malik as a pairing, so I'm definitely gonna be reading this one. Next up we have When No One Is Watching by Alyssa Cole, and this comes out September 15th. If you're noticing a theme, synopsises really bring me in. I don't need to know much, but if you get a hook, I will read you. This one is pitched as Rear Window meets Get Out, and it's set in a gentrifying Brooklyn neighborhood where neighbors are disappearing and you think that they're going to the suburbs to live somewhere else, but now you're not so sure. That is a hook if there ever was one. Having seen both films, I am a huge fan of both films, and this premise sounds amazing. And it needs to be September because I need to read this book. Next up, we have Kingdom of the Wicked by Kerri Maniscalco, and it is being released September 24th. So I've not read Kerri Maniscalco's other book, the Jack the Ripper series. It's been on my TBR, and I've heard wonderful things about it. So even though I haven't read her books yet, I'm kind of having contact excitement for this one. This book is the start of a new series for her, and it follows a girl whose twin has been murdered, and she actually partners with Wrath, who is a prince of hell, in order to help her solve the murders of these women on this island. So that whole thing is a very interesting concept. I don't really need to know more. I'm interested, and I'll probably end up reading her Jack the Ripper series before I read this, but I'm still excited about it. Next up we have The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue by V.E. Schwab, and this is being released on October 6th. Victoria Schwab goes under two different names depending on if it is an adult book or a YA. She goes under Victoria Schwab if it is YA and V.E. Schwab if it is an adult book. And by that fact, that means that The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue is supposed to be an adult book. I read her Monsters of Verity duology and I was really not a fan. I absolutely adored the idea and the writing style was beautiful, but I just didn't connect with that book for whatever reason. So it wasn't for me. However, I do have Villains on my shelf, which I still have yet to read. And this one sounds promising as well. The book is of course about Addie LaRue, who makes a bargain that she is able to live forever, but everyone she meets will never remember her. And that is a very, very unique take on the live forever trope. And there's not much more known about this book, but that alone is such a very interesting concept because of the inherent loneliness that that would bring, as well as the isolation it would bring. So I am very much excited for this one. And I'm hoping that I enjoy it more than her Monsters of Verity duology. But I don't dismiss an author just because I didn't like their work. It just might not be the story for me, and I'll always give chances. Because as I've said before, if I find a synopsis interesting, I will read the book. Next up we have Instant Karma by Marissa Meyer, and that is being released on November 3rd. This one seems like it's gonna be a fun enemies to lovers type of story. Prue, the main character of the book, suddenly wakes up one day and is able to inflict instant karma, both good and bad, on everybody. And I know if I had that ability, yeah, let's just say that's a lot of shenanigans that are gonna happen, and I think this could be a fun one. Next up, we have The Nobleman's Guide to Scandal and Shipwrecks by Mackenzi Lee, and that is being released on December 1st. This is the third book in the Montague Siblings trilogy, and it follows Adrian, who is the youngest brother of Monty and Felicity, who were the protagonists in both The Gentleman's Guide to Vice and Virtue and The Lady's Guide to Petticoats and Piracy. I adore Mackenzi Lee. These books are such wonderful pieces of historical fiction, and the fact that the first one involved a bisexual man in an interracial relationship and the second one involved an asexual woman, I'm very curious of what the youngest of the Montague siblings is going to be like. I don't want to know the plot. I'm already here for it, and I'm very upset that it's coming out December 1st because it's so far away, but I can't wait for this one. Finally, we have A Sky Beyond the Storm by Sabaa, Tahir, and that is also coming out on December 1st. A Sky Beyond the Storm is going to be the fourth and final book in the Ember in the Ashes series, and it needs to come out now. I can't wait for this one. The ending of A Reaper at the Gates was just too much, and I need to know what happens to Laya and Elias and Helene. I only started reading this series this year, so props to all of you guys who have been reading it for the last couple of years, because I don't know how you're waiting for this, but I'm about to explode. I need to know what happens. I need a happy ending for Elias and Laya, and I don't think I'm gonna get it because Sabaa Tahir loves to torture us, I think, because that's the only way I can think of why her characters need to suffer so much. And as a writer, I do the same thing to my characters, so it must be something weird with us writers, but man, I want a happy ending. I don't think that there will be, but I know it's going to be a beautiful book, and I can't wait to read it. This one will definitely be one that I'm going to be reading the first day it drops, because I need to know, and I have to read it. I hope you guys enjoyed that nice list of new releases that are coming out in the second half of 2020. There's a nice mix of historical fiction, own voices, starts of new series, continuations of series, fantasy, thrillers, contemporaries. There's a whole bunch of stuff on there. I'm gonna be putting all the details of the books that I mentioned down below. You can always find that actually in all my videos. I try to include links for that. Let me know what some of your most anticipated releases that haven't been released yet are for 2020. And if there's something that I missed and you want to yell at me about it and tell me to read it, let me know down below and I can add it to my TBR. I'm always looking for new recommendations. I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Thank you for stopping by and I'll see you all later. Bye. Channel, I'm Heather and you're at the... There's some of my most anticipated is dead by next up. Oh, about a Brooklyn. This one fun. This one seems like Cassandra Clare and Wesley Chu, and this comes... Blah, 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 blah.